Addiction affects everybody. It's the leading cause of accidental death in our society. The word itself is derived from the ancient Roman term for enslaved by or bound to. Beating addiction is extremely tough. The drugs and behaviors that lead to it hijack the brain and wreak havoc in your body. Time for some real chemistry talk. Nearly 24 million Americans over the age of 12 are addicted to alcohol or other drugs. That's almost the population of Texas. Years ago, many people thought addiction was just a sign of a flawed character or a lack of willpower, relegated to hobos or hilarious Boston bar-dwelling drunkards. But we now know that's not it. Brain chemistry plays a big part. Our brains like stuff that makes us feel good. It could be alcohol, a jelly donut, a romantic encounter, or all kinds of other stuff. No matter what it is, the things that make you feel good are processed through the brain's reward-seeking pathway. A region deep in the brain called the ventral tegmental area releases a feel-good chemical messenger called dopamine to a region higher up in the brain called the nucleus accumbens. This region is involved in aspects of emotion and motivation. As dopamine surges through the nucleus accumbens, we feel a surge of pleasurable excitement and energy. The surge of dopamine also makes us want to do whatever we just did again. Psychoactive drugs like amphetamines and cocaine supersize this reaction, increasing the amount of available dopamine in the brain by as much as 10 times. The resulting euphoric rush or high recalibrates the brain, making it think that this higher level of dopamine is the new normal. This sets some people on a course toward drug abuse. If a person continues using drugs, the brain adapts to these overwhelming surges by reducing the number of dopamine receptors and making the existing receptors less sensitive to dopamine. This has a double whammy effect on drug users. Fewer dopamine receptors and lower dopamine sensitivity means lower ability to enjoy other everyday activities, like eating donuts. In other words, you need more of a drug, food, or certain activity to get the same pleasurable rush. For drug addicts, that might mean more amphetamines or cocaine to get your brain to produce that surge of dopamine again. If you try to quit, you can go into withdrawal. Think about it. If the drug or activity that was at the controls of your brain is suddenly gone, the brain has no idea what to do. It's like someone hopping off the other side of a seesaw. Your dopamine levels crash and your system goes out of whack. Depressants like alcohol chemically slow down your brain. Alcohol inhibits a molecule called glutamate, which is an excitatory transmitter. It also boosts GABA, which slows down brain activity. To counteract the effects of the depressant, your brain has to produce more adrenaline, more norepinephrine to keep you alert and focused. When you're not drunk, suddenly you don't need that boost, but it's there anyway. This can cause tremors, nausea, difficulty breathing, anxiety, and heart palpitations. Over time, addiction can cause permanent damage to the brain. But this cycle can be broken, and recovering addicts can go on to lead happy and productive lives. Bottom line, if you know somebody who's addicted to something, anything, get them help. There are some great links on recovery and other resources in the description below. Be safe out there, chemheads. Speaking of things that are addictive, check out our episode on iPhones and pizza. And for more weekly chemistry videos, make sure to hit that subscribe button.